Thank you for joining me in the History of Science collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's see what stories are waiting for us from the vault that throw light on the shape of the Earth. In the late 20th century, members of the Flat Earth Society dismissed the evidence of photographs of the Earth from space by insisting that the Apollo moon missions were a hoax. In the late 19th century, you could have read that the Earth is flat in the Zetetic Society journal. Zetetic is derived from a Greek verb meaning to seek or to inquire. The Zetetic Society journal was founded to promote the ideas of this book, Zetetic Astronomy, Earth Not a Globe, published by Samuel Rowbottom in London, 1873, under the pseudonym Parallax. What is the story behind this book and this journal? Why did these moderns believe the Earth was flat? Ironically, they were protesting against the evils of modernism and trying to go back to an idealized pre-modern past in which they thought everyone believed the Earth was flat. By the end of the 19th century, the view was well entrenched that medieval people thought the Earth is flat, so Rowbottom felt bound to agree and promoted the anti-modernist idea of a flat Earth for many years as an itinerant lecturer. The first edition of this book in 1865 contained 220 pages. The second edition almost doubled in thickness. In the copious editions, Rowbottom responded to various critics who, for some reason, reviewed the first edition unfavorably. Rowbottom even issued a 1,000-pound challenge to anyone who could prove him wrong. Alfred Russel Wallace tried unsuccessfully to claim that reward. Yet, the Zetetic Society and the Flat Earth Society are a modern development, not a medieval or early modern movement. They arose in reaction to polarizing rhetoric about scientific authority in the late 19th century. But most people cite them as proof of a pre-modern belief in a flat Earth, which they are not. But didn't Columbus have to prove that the Earth is round? Actually, no. This mistaken modern belief is the true flat Earth myth. The origin of the modern flat Earth myth lies in part with one of America's earliest writers, Washington Irving. Irving's far-fetched life of Columbus presented itself as biography, not fiction. Unfortunately, it was about as factual as the Headless Horseman. Irving fabricated a tale of Columbus pleading his case before a council of inquisitors at a convent in Salamanca, who assailed him with citations from the Bible and the teachings of the church. Irving's account is mischievous nonsense, which should have been read simply as a pleasant romance. Other French and American writers endorsed the flat earth myth, and by the end of the 19th century, it was being taught in elementary schools and universities. In fact, medieval people, both the educated elite and the unlearned laity, knew the Earth is round. Dante's Divine Comedy, for example, assumes the Earth is round. Far from advocating a flat Earth, both Plato and Aristotle assumed that the Earth is a sphere. Wherever their influence held sway, belief in a round Earth was not seriously contested. For Aristotle, the spherical Earth lies in the center of the universe. Surrounding the Earth are giant celestial spheres, the large sphere containing the fixed stars rotates around the Earth every 24 hours, while the planets are carried in spheres around the Earth at different times. Don't confuse an Earth in the middle of the universe with a flat Earth. The Aristotelian cosmos was centered upon the Earth, but the Earth was a globe. Aristotle's theory of gravity stipulated that the natural motion of every earthy body is straight down. So if earthy bodies are falling straight down, then they will compact on every side. Aristotle's theory of gravity required the Earth to be as round as a globe. In another argument for the sphericity of the Earth, Aristotle argued from lunar and solar eclipses. Now, in Aristotle's day, the nature of lunar and solar eclipses was well understood. In a lunar eclipse, the sun, earth, and moon line up on a straight line with the earth in the middle. The sun casts the earth's shadow upon the moon. By the 4th century BC, continuous lunar eclipse observations from Babylon went back several centuries. Now, in every lunar eclipse, to observers located anywhere on the dark side of the earth, north or south or east or west, the earth's shadow on the moon always appears curved. If the earth were flat or any other shape than a globe, at least some of these eclipse shadows would be straight or angular. The curved shadow tells us that the edge of the earth is curved no matter how the earth's shadow is cast onto the moon from any angle. Therefore, the earth must be a three-dimensional globe. We see the earth's silhouette on the face of the moon. So lunar eclipses prove that the far side of the earth is curved. It is not necessary to circumnavigate the globe to behold with our own eyes that the earth is a sphere. So the flat earth myth is not an alleged medieval belief in a flat earth, but the mistaken modern belief that medieval people thought the earth is flat, when it's so easy to show that they knew the earth is round. But myths have a life of their own. Have you seen this woodcut before? To me, this woodcut means that we have set out on a journey of discovery and exploration. I think that is the greatest appeal of the image and the reason it is so frequently reproduced. Yet most people who see it also believe it is evidence for a medieval belief in a flat earth. This woodcut adorns the jacket cover of the best-selling book, The Discoverers, by Daniel Boorstin, a distinguished Librarian of Congress. In fact, you may visit Boorstin's library here in the University of Oklahoma libraries. Yet the inside flap of the book jacket credits the artwork to an early 16th century woodcut. This attribution is mistaken. Similarly, J.D. Bernal, the great Irish scientist, published a monumental four-volume history of science. And in the first volume, Bernal reproduced the woodcut, also attributing it to the 16th century. Yet the woodcut is not from the Middle Ages or even the 16th century at all. It dates to the late 19th century. It was created for this book, published in 1888, Camille Flammarion, The Atmosphere. Camille Flammarion was the Carl Sagan of the 19th century, whose many books inspired and informed a general readership. He bridged astronomy and popular culture. Flammarion's books, published in both French and English, fill several shelves here in the History of Science collections. And in this book, Flammarion created the woodcut to propagandize the flat earth myth. The woodcut has proven to be an extremely durable piece of visual rhetoric, often reproduced by people who have no idea that it originated only in the late 19th century. You may download a colorized version of this woodcut from our website and make a poster or a coffee mug, or use it in whatever way you like. Science is a story. What stories do you want to hear and tell about the shape of the Earth?